Let's try and unpack what's happening on this vase. Let's start all the way at the bottom. Remember, the vase is read from bottom to top. Starting all the way at the bottom, in the first register or section, if we look closely, we see wavy lines. These lines look as though they may represent water. Oftentimes, when people want to depict water, they just create wavy lines on a piece of paper. Moving up to the next section, we see what looks like plants or crops. These are most likely the grains grown by the farmers. And remember, farmers were very important because everybody was paid uniformly in grains. Moving up, we see animals walking in one direction following each other. This seems like a herd of some sort. If we look even closer, we can see that some of the animals have horns while others don't. This can be read as male and female animals alternating. Above the animals, in a larger register, we see nude humans. They are walking in the opposite direction of the animals. They also appear to be carrying various produce and goods. At the top of the vase is the largest register, and the fact that this is the largest register may indicate the importance of what's happening up there. At the top of the vase, we see what looks like a woman, but she's clothed. Art historians believe that this is the goddess Inanna, who was the chief deity of Uruk. Next to her, on the left, is the nude man figure again. He's offering her crops. This looks as though this is a type of ritual where people are bringing offerings to the goddess. The fact that the men are nude are kind of interesting. Perhaps they're one step above the animals. Perhaps this is a way to symbolize their humanness in the presence of something that is a goddess, something that is above human. Behind her are two long poles. These poles represent what looks like an entrance to a temple. Inanna is the largest figure in the whole scene, so the female figure. Oftentimes, scale is used to represent important. Behind her, there seems to be more vessels filled with fruit or goods, along with animals with large horns. This whole vase seems to be a representation of fertility, or fertility of the crops. What do you think? How would you interpret this vase?